I've been waiting for this day for a while now, and my custom three-piece heritage wheels, I am looking at them right now, and they're on the car, and they're more perfect than I could have ever imagined. It completely brings together my Barbie 350Z vision. I love them so much. I am really just at a loss for words, like seeing it all come together. I honestly got used to Adam's wheels being on the car, and these are incredible. It's so amazing. I'm so happy with the direction that I decided to go with them. Huge shout out and thank you again to Heritage Wheels. They could not be more perfect for this car, for me, for my vision, for everything. I am so happy. And before I show you guys though, I need to clean the car up a bit. The car is super, super dirty from my last track day in the rain. And I wanna show you guys this completed vision with a cleaner car. So I'm gonna go wash the car really quick and then give you guys a final reveal. In addition to my custom three-piece wheels coming here, Heritage also sent over 8 more wheels as drift spares. So I can show you guys those if they're not already loaded up on the rig back at the warehouse for an upcoming trip. But I do have a plan for my drift spares. I know a lot of you guys were kind of freaking out that I was gonna be drifting and learning how to tandem and everything for the first time with my three-piece ones. But Heritage has me covered. We have a plan for that. I have another version of their wheels that is a one-piece that I'm gonna be using for all of my intense on-track drifting. So that is the plan. But holy crap, they look so, so good. I cannot wait to show you the car, so I'm gonna hurry up, wash it, and then give you guys the big reveal. Ready for this? I don't know if I'm ready for this. It looks so good, and I haven't had the car this clean in a really, really long time, so oh my gosh, you guys, it is so perfect. It's beautiful. I love it. This is exactly what I wanted and so much more. Oh my gosh. Thank you. It's so perfect and I'm so happy with how they turned out.
I'm not sure if you guys noticed this in the assembly slash pickup video that I filmed at Heritage Wheels back in California. Their wheels come with both valve stems on the outside, and there's also one on the inside. Let me see, focus. I don't know if it'll focus. Oh. And there's one on the inside that we actually just put the opposite way so that it wouldn't be sticking out. The one on the inside was actually hitting my GK Tech angle kit that's on this car. So that is why the one on the inside is flipped inside out so that it doesn't hit anymore. But they made them that way so that if you wanted to put another bolt here, just hardware, and hide this, you're able to do that. But obviously with this being a drift car, I'd like to have access easier from the outside, but that is why they give you two different options there. On the car right now, I have my wheels wrapped in my go-to Kumho tires PS91 compound, both in the front and the rear. I'm running 235 40 18 in the front and 255 35 18s in the rear. It is already set up and good to go for the next drift event. As I mentioned earlier in this video, I do have different wheels by Heritage Wheels that are gonna be used as my drift spares, but I definitely am gonna try and get some track time with these on there as well, just because they're so pretty. But I'm not gonna be trying any like tandeming for the first time with these wheels for obvious reasons. Thank you again to Heritage Wheels for thinking about that and sending me some other ones. I'm not sure if I'll be able to show you my drift spares in this video. We're actually packing up the rig for a trip with this car and they might already be loaded up, but that is the plan. And I do have other wheels, and yes, they are also powder coated neon yellow to match the ones that are on there currently. Honestly, now that I have wheels on this car and it's starting to look more and more complete, this rear bumper is really getting on my nerves now. Like, I know this is my practice drift car and things like that are normally acceptable, but my wheels, the wheels are too nice now. I gotta do something about that. So I'm gonna end up sourcing another rear bumper, get that painted just to make the car look a lot nicer. Every photo I take, I'm always like, ugh, buzzkill. So it's pretty messed up on both sides from when it got hit off by someone at the compound a while back. So I will be doing that. And when I paint the new rear bumper, I'm going to be painting this as well. And I think I've decided to paint that pink and then do like a neon yellow accent here or something like that. Man, I am so happy with how this car has come together. I can't even explain it. Oh yeah, and you can't forget my dual Mishimoto cooler setup in the front here. Looking nice. And my Barbie detail. Now that I have nice wheels on this car too, so many other things are standing out. Like, I'm definitely gonna have to make my calipers nicer now. They're standing out here, the dual caliper setup. You got that one. You got that one looking all gross behind some nice wheels. And my other one as well is pretty gross. Also in the front, the red is just standing out now like a sore thumb. I don't know if you guys can see that well in this video, but the red caliper in the front is gonna start driving me nuts. So there you go. I have more things to do coming up on the channel. Definitely have to paint those calipers and make them look right, like they fit in with everything. Probably pink. Dang, I'm also just appreciating how clean my car is right now. I don't think I've ever had it this clean. I've been really abusing it, just taking it from drift event to drift event. And because it's been raining so much here, it's been hard to get the motivation up to actually give the car a proper wash, but man, it looks so good. And yes, I know. I still have to redo my tint. I've decided that I'm gonna do it neon yellow and have it done by a professional just so that I can avoid any further mistakes. It was cool to see like how to do it and learn myself so that if I ever got in a bind where I really, really wanted to do tint and had no other options, I could do it. But I might take it to someone for my second try. Maybe learn with them, be there kind of assisting. Not sure yet, but I know, guys. I know, I'm working on it.
That is it for this video.
I'm so happy with how everything is coming together on this car. And it's just so great to me that not only is the vision coming together on the outside, but I am also driving the crap out of this car and getting so much seat time. I haven't been this happy in a really long time. The fact that I've been able to drive as much as I have been has been so incredible. I feel like I'm able to progress a decent amount every time I get on track, which is making me love this car even more. And I am really, really excited for the upcoming trip with this car. It's gonna be so much fun, and it revolves around driving a lot more as well. Stay tuned, and I will see you guys in the next video.